Good morning. Now, in today's class, we will talk about the meninges and cerebrospinal fluids. I hope you're familiar with these two words. Meninges, that is the, you can see it's a brain layer. I say the protection of the brain, brain cover, and the cerebrospinal fluids. That means the fluid present in the cerebral brain. Fluids present in the brain, that will be the CSF, cerebrospinal fluids. So I will tell you about these two important topics today. Before going to start the lecture, we must understand why we are going to study these topics, why we are talking about the meninges, why we are going to study about the cerebrospinal fluids. So let's see what will be the objective and then what will be the learning outcome of these two topics. Like the objective of this topic is that by learning this subtopic, you are able to understand which structures are protecting the brain. Okay, so which type of structure are those that is protect the brain, and how old is the brains? Because you know, lots of the jerk and pressure, exertions, and the forces is there. So how they can protect the brain? How can they provide the support through the brain? What will the properties of these three different layers of the brain, that is called the meninges? So that will be the objectives. And after learning these topics, you are able to understand the protection of the brain. Okay, and you can explain the structure in place during the movement, mechanical suspension, and the flotation in the CSF. You can provide the structure where the CSF will float. You can explain about the different biomatter and duramatter. So you all things you will be learned today. Now let's start the class. Meninges is the very familiar and authentic words. So these are the connective tissue covering that encircle the spinal cord and brain. Sorry. So meninges are the three connective tissue. ये तीन connective tissues हैं जो called जिनको group में हम एक meninges कह देते हैं. Okay? That will cover the spinal cord and brain. जो brain और spinal cords दोनों को cover करने का काम करते हैं. Okay? So brain in the central nervous system is also covered by them, and the spinal cords which are the parts of the central nervous system. So brain and spinal cord both are covered by these three connective tissue, that is called the meninges. The spinal meninges surround the spinal cord and are continuous with the cranial meninges, which encircle the brain. So if the meninges are surrounding the spinal cord, that will be called the spinal meninges, and when the meninges that will cover the brain, that will call the cranial meninges. So you can say it is the spinal meninges and the cranial meninges. The most superficial of the three spinal meninges will be the dura mater, that is a very tough, okay, and it is also called the tough mother. It's composed of dense irregular connective tissue. So the most superficial of the three spinal meninges, tino spinal jo meninges hain, teen hote hain, dura mater, pia mater, and arachnoid mater, we will discuss later. So you have to understand in these three layer, in these three spinal meninges, the most outer, जो सबसे बाहर का, जो सबसे superficial layer है, that will be very tough. Okay, it will composed of the dense irregular connective tissue, and it form a sac from the level of the foramen magnum in the occipital bone. Okay, so it will form a sac like a structure that will started from the foramen magnum to the occipital bone, and where it continues with the dura mater of the brain to the second sacral vertebra. The spinal cord is also protected by the cushion of a fat and connective tissue located in the epidural space. So jo hum spinal cords ki baat kar rahe hain, to spinal cord also protected hai kisse? A cushion of fat, ek jo fat hai, jo gaddinuma jo fat hai, cushion fat, and the connective tissue jo locate ho rahe hain kahan pe? Epidural space mein. And what is the epidural space? That will be between the dura mater and the wall of vertebral canal. Jo vertebral canal ki wall hai aur jo dura mater hai, इनके बीच का जो स्पेस है, एपिड्यूरल स्पेस. द मिडिल मीनिंग्स इज देयर, सिंगुलर फॉर्म ऑफ मेनिंजीज। अगर हम मेनिंजीज की बात कर रहे हैं तो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑल थ्री लेयर, बट व्हेन वी से द मेनिंग्स दैट मींस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सिंगल लेयर, आइदर इट कैन बी पाया, आइदर इट कैन बी ड्यूरा, आइदर इट कैन बी अरेकनॉइड। सो द मिडल मेनिंग्स, जो मिडल की बात कर रहे हैं हम, इज एन अवैस्कुलर कवरिंग कॉल्ड द अरेकनॉइड मैटर। जो बीच में है, सबसे सुपरफिशियल कौन सा हो गया, टफ मैटर, या यू कैन से ड्यूरा मैटर। इसके बाद अरेकनॉइड मैटर सेंटर में, और मिडिल में अरेकनॉइड मैटर, मिडिल मेनिंग्स जो है ये अवैस्कुलर है। अरेकनॉइड दैट मींस लाइक द स्पाइडर, ओल्ड सिमिलर टू, बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स स्पाइडर वेब अरेंजमेंट ऑफ डेलिकेट कोलेजन फाइबर्स एंड सम इलास्टिक फाइबर, सो इट विल बी कॉल्ड द अरेकनॉइड मैटर। इट इज डीप टू द ड्यूरा मैटर एंड इज कंटिन्यूअस विद द अरेकनॉइड मैटर ऑफ द ब्रेन। So between the dura mater and the arachnoid mater is a thin subdural space. So ke teen layer hai. So layers ke beech mein space honge. So similarly jo outer layer hai, jo dura mater hai, okay? And middle is the arachnoid mater. So there is a space between the dura mater and arachnoid mater that will be a called subdural space. Aur is subdural space mein kya hoga? Interstitial fluids will present. The innermost meninges. So sabse last ki jo layer hai, that will be the pia matter, a very delicate matter, a very thin transparent connective tissue that adheres to the surface of the spinal cord and brain, jo spinal cord ke surface aur brain pe adheres honge. So hum brain ke covering ki baat kare ya spinal cord se covering ki baat kare, so these are covered with the three layers. The first layer that is most superficial to the brain or spinal cord, you can say, yeah, you can say that is most adhere to the spinal cord and brain, that will a very thin transparent connective tissue that will be called a pia mater. Iske baad dusra hai arachnoid mater, that is a fibrous connective tissue like you can see here, okay? Arachnoid mater fiber structures, collagen fibers ke bane hote hain, okay? And elastic fibers ke bane hote hain. And then superficial most outer layer, that will be the tough matter or dura matter, that is a dense connective tissue, okay? Now it consists of a squamous to cuboidal cell within the interlacing bundles of collagen fibers and some fiber, fine elastic fibers. Within the pia mater are many blood vessels. Iske pehle humne arachnoid matters ko dekha tha, which avascular tha, jisme blood vessels nahi honge, but इन पायामेटर में, पायामेटर जब हम बात करें, इसमें ब्लड वेसल्स होंगे जो क्या करते हैं, सप्लाई करेंगे ऑक्सीजन एंड न्यूट्रिएंट्स टू द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड्स एंड ब्रेन। सो द ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड्स आर टेकिंग द न्यूट्रिशन, टेकिंग द ऑक्सीजन थ्रू द ब्लड वेसल, दैट विल इन द पायामेटर। सो बिटवीन द अरेकनॉइड मैटर एंड द पायामेटर इज द सब अरेकनॉइड स्पेस। इफ यू रिमेंबर, we already talk about the between the dura mater and arachnoid mater space is the subdural space, okay? Teen layer honge, 1, 2, 3, so there is a two gap. Agar teen layer hai, theek hai, teen meninges hain, to inke beech mein do gap honge, between the tough dura mater or arachnoid mater subdural, and between the arachnoid mater and the pia mater sub arachnoid. So yes, between the arachnoid matter and pia matter is a space that is called the subarachnoid space, which contains also the interstitial fluids, or you can say the cerebrospinal fluids. Yahan pe ye kya hai, yahan pe it is called the cerebrospinal fluids that serve as a shock absorber, as suspension system for the spinal cord and brain. Here this fluid that is called the cerebrospinal fluid will work, serve as a shock absorber, jo ek tarah se shock absorber ka kaam karenge. That means when there is a high pressure, when there is any type of the injury, when there is any type of the trauma or hard pressure or heavy jerk is going to exert it in the brain, then this CSF will absorb that shock and is also helping the suspension system for the spinal cord and brain. All three spinal meninges, we are talking about these three spinal meninges, that is the outer layer, most outer is the dura mater, then second will be arachnoid mater, and the third is a pia mater. So all three spinal meninges cover the spinal nerve roots up to the point, okay? So if these all three nerve spinal meninges that will cover the spinal nerve root up to the point where they exit the spinal column through the intervertebral foramen. So this meninges is going to cover the whole spinal nerve roots, and up to the point where they exit the spinal column. So nerve roots are the structure that connect the spinal nerve to the spinal cord, and nerve roots are those structure that is connecting wo connect kar rahe kise spinal nerves ko spinal cord se. So triangular shaped membranous extension of the pia mater suspended the spinal cord in the middle of its dural sheath. These extension called the denticulate ligament are thickening of the pia mater. They project laterally and fuse with the arachnoid mater and the inner surface of the dura mater between the anterior and posterior nerve roots of spinal nerve on either side. So they project laterally, okay, and fuse with the arachnoid mater. Abhi laterally project ho rahe hain aur kisse fuse ho rahe hain? Arachnoid mater se ho rahe hain, jo middle layer hai, and the inner surface of the dura mater aur dura mater ke inner surface se. Between the anterior and posterior nerve roots of spinal nerves on either side. Extending all along the length of the spinal cords, the denticulate ligaments protect the spinal cord against the sudden displacement that could result in the shock. Now you can see here the meninges of the brain. Protecting layer covering the central nervous system. We know it is protecting the brain and the spinal cord. So yes, and the brain and spinal cord both are the part of the CNS, central nervous system. So yes, meninges is protecting layer of the central nervous system. Three layer, dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater. Meningitis derived from the meninges. Meningitis is a disease, that is the inflammation in the meninges. So that will be called the meningitis. Now, dura mater is Latin form that is called a tough mother. Okay, so thick and durable membranes. Closer to the skull, जो skull के सबसे नजदीक होगी, जो हमारे skull खोपड़ी है, उसके सबसे नजदीक होगी, because brain is protecting by this. So yes, dura mater is close to the skull, composed of dense connective, support venous channels, and that will be these between the these two membranes. Middle part of the meninges, arachnoid mater is the middle part of the meninges. You can see here, it is a brain that is enclosed in the skull, and this skull whose are enclosing the brain having the dura mater that is the most outer, then arachnoid mater is the between, and then pia mater is the last, and then the brain tissue will be there. Arachnoid mater is a wave like structure. You can see there it is made up of the fiber and elastin collagens, provide gushing effect, and thin transparent membrane and impermeable to the fluids. So these are the arachnoid maters. Pia mater ki baat kare, you can also see the skull having the look like this. If you see, then there is a dura mater, pia mater, and arachnoid mater. Latin for soft mother. Pia mater is a Latin word that is having, it is also called the soft mother. Like the dura mater is a tough mother, it is a soft mother. Adheres to the surface brain, thin membrane, and impermeable to fluids. It is also impermeable to fluids, and large blood supply. So it is a vascular in nature. स्पेस की बात करें, हमने दो स्पेस देखा था. एक स्पेस था जो ड्यूरा मैटर और अरेक्नॉइड मैटर के बीच में था, जिसको सब ड्यूरल स्पेस बोला हमने. दूसरा था अरेक्नॉइड मैटर एंड पाया मैटर के बीच में, जिसको सब अरेक्नॉइड स्पेस कहा गया, जिसमें सीएसएफ फील्ड है. सो सब अरेक्नॉइड स्पेस कंटेन द सेरेब्रो स्पाइनल फ्लूइड एंड इज बिटवीन द अरेक्नॉइड एंड द पाया मैटर. वी नो इट एक्टिव इन द ब्लड ब्रेन बैरियर. ओके, थ्रू इंजरी dura mater and arachnoid mater that will separate and form the subdural space. You will see here, it is a skin of scalp. Hamare jo scalp ki jo skin hai, sabse outer layer ki jo hamare khopde ki scale hai, that is the scalp of the skin. Then periostem is there. After the periostem, you will see the bone of the skull. Ab ye skull hai, okay? Khopde ki hamari jo bone hoti hai, skulls hoti hai, this is the bone of the skull. Then you will see there is a dura mater. So it's this structure is a hard, you can say dense connective tissue, dura mater. And after dura mater, it will be the arachnoid mater that looks like a spider web like structure made up of the collagen and elastin fibers. And after the arachnoid mater, then you will see there is a pia mater that is a soft tissue, a soft mother, and made up of the very thin transparent connective tissue. That is the also this is all the whole the part of the arachnoid mater. Superior sagittal sinus space is there. subdural space, subdural, that is between the dura mater and the arachnoid mater. Then you will see the subarachnoid space, between space between the arachnoid and the biomater. These are the inferior horn structure. These are the lateral ventricle structure. You can see these are also interior horn. And interventricular foramen is there. Third ventricle is there. When I will teach you about the ventricles, then you it is also help you. Cerebral aqueduct, fourth ventricle, central canal, posterior horn. Now come to the cerebrospinal fluids. Cerebrospinal fluid is a clear colorless liquid that protect the brain and spinal cord from chemical and physical injury. Agar hum baat kar rahe hain cerebrospinal fluids ki, it is a clear and colorless liquid. It's clear or colorless liquid hai jo protect kar raha hai brain and spinal cords ko, kisse, from chemical and physical injury. If any chemicals are is there reaching into the brain, then they have to encounter with the CSF. CSF will remove them, protect the brain. Either if there is any physical injuries there, then CSF will act as a shock absorber. It will help them. So CSF will protect the brain from chemical and physical both type of the injury. It also carries the oxygen, glucose, and other needed chemicals from the blood to the neurons and neuroglia. So not only to protect in the form of the chemical and physical injury from the chemical physical injury, it will also carries the oxygen, glucose, and the other needed chemicals from the blood vessels, from the blood to the neurons and neuroglia. So CSF continuously circulate through the cavities in the brain and the spinal cord and around the brain and the spinal cord in the subarachnoid space between the arachnoid and biomater. So this cerebrospinal fluid is circulating these oxygen, glucose, and other required nutrients, required materials, required needed chemicals to the all the areas of the brain. The total value of CSF is 80 to 150 ml in adult. CSF mainly contains the glucose, protein, lactic acid, urea, cation is there, anions is there. It also contains some white blood cell. The cerebrospinal fluids contribute to the homeostasis in three main ways: mechanical protection, chemical protection, and circulation. Okay, so in the later slide I will show you some figure is also there with as the four CSF filled cavities within the brain which are called the ventricles. Okay, so when I will teach you the ventricle, then you can see there is the ventricle that will filled with the cerebrospinal fluids. Now here we can see the cerebrospinal fluid is not only maintaining the these thing, but it will also have to maintain the homeostasis by the three way: mechanically, chemically, and circulation. A lateral ventricle is located in each hemisphere of the cerebrum. Hum lateral ventricles ki baat kare jo locate hote hain each hemisphere of the cerebrum mein. Anteriorly, the lateral ventricles are separated by thin membrane that is called the septum pallidum. The third ventricle is a narrow cavity along the midline superior to the hypothalamus and between the right and left half of the thalamus. The fourth ventricle lies between the brain stem and the cerebellum. The site of CSF production are the choroid plexus. Ab CSF ka production kahan pe hota hai? CSF banta kahan pe hai? The location of production of the cerebrospinal fluids are the choroid plexus. It is a membrane like structure, network of blood capillaries in the wall of ventricle. Jo ventricles ki jo walls hoti hain jisme choroid plexus paaye jate hain, microscopic blood vessels hote hain, usme CSF bante hain, cerebrospinal fluids bante hain. These capillaries are covered by the ependymal cells that form the cerebrospinal fluids from blood plasma by filtration and secretion. अब ये CSF बन कैसे रहे हैं? ये CSF ठीक वैसे ही बन रहे हैं जैसे किडनी ब्लड को फिल्टर करती है और यूरिन बनाती है. ठीक वैसे ही inside these ventricle wall there is a choroid plexus जिसमें बहुत सारे microscopic blood vessels होते हैं and there is a ependymal cells. So these are ependymal cells is filter the blood plasma. Okay, and the fluid is passing through them, that will be the cerebrospinal fluids. So ependymal cells क्या करती है, cerebrospinal fluids बनाती है from the blood plasma by the filtration and secretion. So कहाँ बनता है, choroid plexus पे बनता है. Okay, और ये कहाँ पे है, इट इज इन द वॉल ऑफ वेंट्रिकल. और एक क्या है, ये एक नेटवर्क है, किसकी, ब्लड कैपिलरीज की. ब्लड कैपिलरी की एक नेटवर्क है. प्लेक्सस का मतलब क्या होता है, एक नेटवर्क. कोरायड प्लेक्सस, अ मेम्ब्रेन लाइक ब्लड नेटवर्क प्रेजेंट इन द वेंट्रिकल्स, जहां पे एंटीपिनाइमल सेल्स फिल्ट्रेशन और सिक्रेशन के थ्रू ब्लड प्लाज्मा को से सेपरेट करती है सीएसएफ को. लोकेशन ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल्स विद इन अ ट्रांसपेरेंट मेम्ब्रेन, वन इंट्रावेंट्रिकुलर फोरामेन ऑन ईच साइड कनेक्ट द लेटरल वेंट्रिकल टू द थर्ड वेंट्रिकल एंड द एक्वाडक्ट ऑफ द मिड ब्रेन कनेक्ट द थर्ड वेंट्रिकल टू द फोर्थ वेंट्रिकल. यू कैन सी देयर इज अ इंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर व्यू. इन इंटीरियर व्यू यू कैन सी देयर इज अ लेटरल वेंट्रिकल, इंटरवेंट्रिकल फोरामेन, थर्ड वेंट्रिकल इज देयर, एक्वाडक्ट ऑफ द मिड ब्रेन दैट इज कॉल्ड द सेरेब्रल एक्वाडक्ट, पॉन्स, मिडल ऑफ ब्रांकेटा एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड्स. फ्रॉम पोस्टीरियर साइड यू कैन सी द सेरेब्रम इज देयर, then fourth ventricle, lateral aperture, cerebellum, median aperture and central canal. कंपोजिशन की बात करें, अच्छा और एक अच्छी चीज मैं आपको बताऊं, सेरेब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड जब हम सीएसएफ की जो बात करते हैं, यू नो ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ द इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड जो होती हैं, व्हेन व्हेन दीज इंटरस्टिशियल फ्लूइड जो सेल्स की फ्लूइड्स होती हैं, दीज आर माइग्रेटिंग एवरीवेयर, सो देयर नेम विल बी चेंज्ड. सो यही फ्लूइड्स जो ब्लड प्लाज्मा से बन रहा है ब्रेन में, दैट विल बी द सेरेब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड्स. नाइन सेरेब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड्स विल कंटेन्स द 99.13% वाटर एंड 0.87% सॉलिड. नाउ दीज ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस, अब ये जो सॉलिड है, दीज सॉलिड हैविंग सम ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस एंड सम इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस, दोनों होंगे इसमें. 99.13% तो इसमें वाटर हो गए, 99.13% वाटर के अलावा जो 0.87% सॉलिड्स हैं, इसमें इनऑर्गेनिक और ऑर्गेनिक दोनों मटेरियल्स होंगे, लाइक प्रोटीन, अमीनो एसिड, सुगर, कोलेस्ट्रॉल, यूरिया, यूरिक एसिड, क्रिएटिनिन, लैक्टिक एसिड, दीज आर द ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस. सोडियम, कैल्शियम, पोटेशियम, मैग्नीशियम, क्लोराइड, फॉस्फेट, बाइकार्बोनेट, सल्फेट, दीज आर द इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस. ओके, सो ये जितने भी जो आयंस की बात कर रहे हैं हम, जो भी इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस है और जो भी ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस हैं, these are present in the form of in the only in the 0.87%. as a csf ki baat kare agar hum, as a csf is a part of the ecf, extracellular fluid, therefore it contain more amount of sodium than potassium, it contains some lymphocyte. csf secreted by the ventricles does not contains any cell. The lymphocytes are added when it flows into the spinal cord. So CSF जब ventricles से secrete हो रहा है, earlier in the slide I mentioned that CSF will contain some little bit white blood cells. Okay, lymphocytes. But CSF when secreted from the ventricles, it does not contains any cell. It is only the fluids. But when it will be travel, when it will be move, then there is a lymphocyte is added in the CSF in the spinal cords. Formation of CSF ki baat karein. It is formed by the choroid plexus situated within the ventricles. The choroid plexus are tuft of capillary projection present inside the ventricles and covered by the pia mater and ependymals covering. How it forms? By the process of secretion. Does not involve the ultrafiltration or dialysis, it does not involve, uses the energy, and active transport mechanism is involved in the secretion. So it will be processed by the active transport protein. So there's a filtration and secretion is there by which the CSF will be formed. Absorption of CSF ki baat karein, mostly absorbed by the arachnoid villi into the dural sinuses and the spinal veins. A small amount is absorbed along the perineural spaces into the cervical lymphatics and into the perivascular spaces. Normally 500 ml of CSF is formed every day and equal amount is absorbed. लगभग 500 ml CSF प्रतिदिन बनते हैं और ये प्रतिदिन एब्जॉर्ब भी हो जाते हैं, और एब्जॉर्ब कहां से होंगे, बाय द एरेक्नॉइड विलाई इनटू द ड्यूरल साइनसेस एंड स्पाइनल वेंस. हाउ इट विल बी एब्जॉर्ब, बाय फिल्ट्रेशन ड्यू टू द प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट बिटवीन द हाइड्रोस्टैटिक प्रेशर इन द सबड्यूरल स्पेस फ्लूइड. सो बाय फिल्ट्रेशन, फिल्ट्रेशन के थ्रू ड्यू टू द प्रेशर ग्रेडियंट बिटवीन द हाइड्रोस्टैटिक प्रेशर इन द सबड्यूरल स्पेस फ्लूइड and the pressure that exists in the dural sinus blood. So these are absorbed due to the pressure difference in the subarachnoid space fluid, jo subarachnoid space hai, the space between the arachnoid matter and pyometer ke beech mein jo subarachnoid space hai, usme jo hydrostatic pressure hai, because why, because they are filled with the cerebrospinal fluids. So usme jo pressure hai aur jo pressure exist karta hai in the dural sinus bloods mein. So the filtration is only possible due to the these pressure gradient, and colloidal substance passes slowly and crystalloid are absorbed rapidly. CSF ki functions ki baat kare, the protection function, yes, it act as a buffer also. Ye buffer ki tarah kaam karte hain, andar ke environment ko maintain karte hain, homeostasis ko banaye rakhenge, brain ko protect karte hain from the shock se. It act as a absorber, shock absorber. If the brain receive the severe blow, counter cough injury may take place. Agar brain pe koi severe blow, koi hamla karta hai, kisi tarah ki koi trauma, koi injury hoti hai, so thus this CSF will counter the attack. Regulation of cranial content volume is very essential, because when substance are absorbed into the venous sinuses, intracranial pressure is raised. जब substance absorb होते हैं venous sinuses में, so जो intracranial जो pressure है, वो increase हो जाता है. And intracranial pressure in turns interfere with the cerebral circulation, causing the asphyxia. Okay, so when the intracranial pressure, now you can understand what will be the intracranial pressure. Intracranial pressure are the pressure that will be present inside the cranium. Jo cranium mein jo pressure develop ho raha hai, that will be the intracranial pressure. Aur ye kaise ho raha hai? By absorbing the substance into the venous sinuses. Jo ye venous sinuses mein substance absorb ho rahe hain, these absorption will increase the pressure in the cranium, that will be called the intracranial pressure. And this intracranial pressure in turn the interferes with the cerebral circulation, jo hamare cerebral mein circulations ho rahe hain. Okay, so during the circulation, because we know in the circulation there is the oxygen is there that supplied in our brain cells, but when there is a pressure is arises in the brain, that will disturb this circulation and causing the asphyxia. Asphyxia is a condition when there is not enough oxygen is gained by these brain cells. And you know, it is a life-threatening situation. Now we know, when there is no oxygen in the brain, then what will happen, we all knows. So that is a condition, asphyxia. So intracranial pressure will interfere with the cerebral circulation. So cerebral circulation may interfere karenge, or cerebral circulation is only way to transport the oxygen molecules to the every nerve cells inside the brain. So it is prevented by the greater absorption of CSF to give the space for the increase the cranial content. So we can prevent these things by the greater absorption of the CSF, which given the space for the increasing the cranial content. Medium of exchange is there. CSF is the medium through which substance like the nutritive substance, waste material are exchanged between the blood and brain tissue. Okay, so CSF is not only that is the these things, but also helping in the exchange. They can take the nutritive substances, they can give the waste material to the blood. So ye blood se vessel se kaise exchange bhi karte hain. Collected by cisternal puncture or lumbar puncture. In cisternal puncture, CSF is collected by passing needles between the occipital pores. How can the CSF collected? CSF agar main collect karna ho to kaise karenge? Do tarike hain, ek cisternal puncture kar sakte hain, dusra lumbar puncture kar sakte hain. Lumbar puncture kar sakte hain, main spinal cord ke through bhi hum nikal sakte hain through the lumbar areas se. And cisternal puncture इज सी एस एफ इज कलेक्टेड बाई पासिंग अ नीडल बिटवीन द ऑसिपिटल बोन एंड एटलस. हमारा जो एटलस है और ऑसिपिटल बोन्स है, ठीक है, इनके बीच में, ठीक है, इनके थ्रू वी कैन पास अ नीडल्स इन बिटवीन देम, बिटवीन द ऑसिपिटल बोन एंड एटलस. So it will, the needles will enter into the cisterna magna, and then we can collect the CSF. Other is the lumbar puncture. Lumbar puncture needle is introduced into the subarachnoid space in the lumbar nature. जो subarachnoid space है, जो space है between the arachnoid matter and the pia matter, जिसमें CSF filled है, उस region में needle को हम insert करते हैं lumbar region में. Between the third and fourth lumbar spine, जो तीसरी और चौथी lumbar spines है, वैसे we know the lumbar spines, how many lumbars we have, the five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lumbar vertebrae is there. Between the third and fourth lumbar spines, we can insert the needle and take the fluids. Use of lumbar punctures की बात करें, what is the use of lumbar puncture? Collecting the CSF for diagnostic purpose, injecting the drugs for spinal anesthesia. Okay. If we are giving the spinal anesthesia, analgesia, and the chemotherapy, then we must have the inject into the between the lumbar region and third and fourth lumbar vertebra. Measuring pressure exerted by the CSF. Blood cerebrospinal fluid barrier. You know, we have know about the blood brain barrier. That means those barrier which protecting the passing of the substance into the blood. Blood. So the substance cannot cross the blood-brain barrier. Those substance who are cross the blood-brain barrier, it will only allow to go inside the brain. Otherwise, those who cannot pass the blood-brain barrier, it will not allow to go inside the brain. Similarly, they have a blood cerebrospinal fluid barrier. A barrier between the blood and cerebrospinal fluids exists at the choroid plexus, similar to the BBB, blood-brain barrier. Allow the movement of only those substances which are allowed by the BBB. The CSF barrier will also allow only those substances who can pass through the blood-brain barrier. Now, which substances can pass through the blood cerebrospinal fluid barrier? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, water, glucose, amino acid, electrolytes, drugs like the levodopa, 5-hydroxytryptamine, 5-ST, sulfonamides, tetracycline, other lipid-soluble drugs can be easily passed through these barriers. Anesthetic gases like the ether, nitrous oxide, which are lipid soluble, other lipid soluble substances easily passed. Those substances which can't pass through the blood cerebrospinal barrier, like the injurious chemical agent, pathogen like bacterias, drugs such as the penicillin and catecholamines, dopamine also can't pass. Okay, because these are not a lipid soluble. We know the dopamine is also can't pass the in the brain, so Parkinson is treated with the L-dopa instead of dopamine. Bile pigments ki baat kare, however, barrier is not well developed in infants. The bile pigments enter the brain tissue. In infants, in the childs, we know the child's organ is not fully developed. So yes, there is barrier is not well developed. So in the infants, in the children's, in the very neonates, the bile pigments can enter into the brain. During the jaundice in infants, the bile pigments enter the brain and causes the damage of the basal ganglia and leading to carnic teras. Okay, we know bile pigment is there. Agar hum bile pigments ki baat kare, bile pigments, we know how it will be secreted through the liver and stored in the gallbladder, and then it will be released the process. But in infants, in the cases of the jaundice, agar hum jaundice ki baat kare, we know the jaundice, okay, where the bile pigment is going to increased. So this bile pigment can be reached, can be crossed this cerebrospinal fluid barrier and can be reached into the brain of the infants. Now this condition will lead to damage to the basal ganglia. So when the bile pigment is reaches to the brain, it will causes damage to the basal ganglia, and that will causes the carnic teras. It is a type of brain damage that can result from the high level of bilirubin in the baby's bloods. So bilirubin ki matra badh jane se, there is a type of brain damage, and it can cause the ectoid cerebral palsy and the hearing loss. Jo cerebral palsies hote hain, hearing losses hote hain, these are can be caused by the these connectors or increasing the bilirubin in the baby's brain. Also causes problem with the vision, vision ka problem hogi, and the teeth sometimes can the intellectual disability jo hamari intellectual hoti hai, it can be also hampered by this process. Hydrocephalus ki baat kare, CSF disorder kaun kaun se, hydrocephalus is there, abnormal accumulation of the cerebrospinal fluids in the skull with the enlargement of the head. हेड का एनलार्जमेंट हो जाना क्योंकि सीएसएफ का एक्युमुलेट हो रहा है, दैट इज द हाइड्रोसेफेलस. टू टाइप्स हो सकते हैं, नॉन कम्युनिकेटिंग एंड कम्युनिकेटिंग. नॉन कम्युनिकेटिंग हाइड्रोसेफेलस की बात करें या इंटरनल हाइड्रोसेफेलस की बात करें, इट इज ड्यू टू द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एनी ऑफ द फोरामेन थ्रू विच द सीएसएफ एस्केप, रिजल्टिंग डायलेशन ऑफ वेंट्रिकुलर एक्टिविटी. सीएसएफ जिसके थ्रू एस्केप कर रहे हैं, अगर इफ दे आर ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इज देयर, देन सीएसएफ इज गोना टू एक्युमुलेट, देन द एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ द हेड विल बी पॉसिबल. Second is the communicable hydrocephalus, like the due to the blockage of arachnoid villi. Blockage of arachnoid villi means arachnoid villi is going to absorb the CSF. So CSF will be produced, but it will be not absorbed. So it will going to accumulate. Symptoms of hydrocephalus is the headache, vomiting, atrophy of the brain, mental weakness, and convulsion, like the seizures will be there. नॉर्मल प्रेशर हाइड्रोसेफेलस की बात करें, सेम एज कम्युनिकेटिंग द हाइड्रोसेफेलस, बट इट इज ड्यू टू द डिक्रीज द सीएसएफ एब्जॉर्प्शंस. सिम्टम्स की बात की जाए तो इट विल गेट इनस्टेबिलिटी, यूरिनरी इनकंटिनेंस एंड डिमेंशिया. नाउ वी हैव द क्विज. इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग प्लेस वुड यू नॉट बी फाइंड सेरेब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड्स. ऐसे कौन सा प्लेस है जिसमें आप सीएसएफ फाइंड नहीं करते हैं? सब एरेक्नॉइड स्पेस इसमें तो होता है. थर्ड वेंट्रिकल ऑफ द ब्रेन, वेंट्रिकल्स में भी होते हैं. द एपिड्यूरल स्पेस एंड द सेंट्रल कैनाल ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, स्पाइनल कॉर्ड्स में भी होंगे, स्पाइनल कॉर्ड में, एपिड्यूरल स्पेस में नहीं होंगे. सो यस, एपिड्यूरल स्पेस इज देयर. आंसर सी इज करेक्ट. वेयर इज द सेरेब्रोस्पाइनल फ्लूइड फाउंड? कहां पाया जाता है? बिटवीन द पाया मैटर एंड द ब्रेन, पाया मैटर और ब्रेन के बीच में. Between the dura mater and arachnoid mater, between the dura mater and the pia mater, between the arachnoid mater and the brain. Yes, it will found between the arachnoid mater and the brain. You can see subdural subarachnoid space between the arachnoid mater and the pia mater. So that will be the brain. So yes, answer D is correct. What is the blood-brain barrier? It is the inner two meninges that surround the brain. It is formed by the capillaries of choroid plexus and ependymal cell. It is the endothelial cell of capillaries that supply the brain and their astrocyte. It is cerebrospinal fluids that bathes the brain. So we know the blood-brain barrier is the endothelial cell of the capillaries that supplies the brain and their astrocytes. So answer C is correct. What is found between the arachnoid and pia mater? Arachnoid matter, pia matter के बीच में क्या पाया जाता है? Adipose tissue, venous sinuses, choroid plexus, cerebrospinal fluids. So yes, cerebrospinal fluids. So answer D is correct. Which one of the following is not a function of the cerebrospinal fluids? इसमें से ऐसा कौन सा है जो CSF का function नहीं है? To produce hormone, ये नहीं है. It is not a function. To transport nutrients around the brain, yes, CSF is transport the nutrients around the brain. See. To protect the spinal cord, yes, it protect the spinal cord. To cushion the brain, yes, it acts as a cushion the brain. So answer A is correct. Okay, the CSF will not produce the hormones. Next question: which molecule has the greatest effect in controlling the lung ventilation? Which molecule has greatest effect in controlling lung ventilation? So we know carbon dioxide in the blood having the greatest effect in controlling the lung ventilation. Oxygen in the blood is not. Hydrogen ions in the blood is not. Oxygen in the CSF is not, so C is correct. What are the three meninges and two named spaces that surround the brain? Kya naam hai unke? In order to form the superficial to the deep, we are talking about the superficial to deep, upar se niche ki taraf agar hum baat kare, outermost to innermost layers ki baat kare. So what are the three meninges? We know the most outer layer is the dura mater, then arachnoid matter, then pia mater. So if you see what are the three meninges and two named spaces that surround the brain. So epidural, dura, arachnoid, subarachnoid and pia. Yes, it is correct. सबसे बाहर जो स्पेस है वो एपिड्यूरल स्पेस है, उसके बाद ड्यूरा मैटर्स है, फिर अरेक्नॉइड मैटर्स है, फिर सब अरेक्नॉइड स्पेस है एंड सब पाया मैटर्स है. ओके, देयर इज आल्सो सब ड्यूरल स्पेस बिटवीन द ड्यूरा एंड अरेक्नॉइड. सो आंसर डी इज करेक्ट हियर. व्हिच लेयर ऑफ मेम्ब्रेन अराउंड द ब्रेन इज द मोस्ट सुपरफिशियल. ब्रेन की कौन सी लेयर है जो सबसे सुपरफिशियल लेयर है. सो वी नो द टफ मटर, dura mater is there, so yes, answer is correct. What do the descending tract of his spinal cord contain? जो spinal cord के descending tracts होते हैं, वो क्या contains कर रहे हैं? White matter and transmit the second sensory information. White matter and transmit the motor commands. Gray matter and transmit the sensory information. Gray matter and transmit the motor commands. It will be a white matter. जो descending tracts होते हैं spinal cord के, it will be a white matter and will be transmit the motor commands. So answer B is correct. One of the following is not a meninge. अब इसमें से ऐसी कौन सी है जो meninges नहीं है? Pia mater है, ulna mater, arachnoid mater, dura mater. So we know ulna mater is nothing. So here the answer B is correct, ulna mater. Now these are the reference book, and also I will tell you that in this topic we discuss about the first meninges, and then there are three different meninges is there. Like the most outer layer is the dura mater, and then arachnoid mater, and the space between dura and arachnoid is the subdural space, and the most inner layer that is just cover the brain, that will be the pia mater, and the space between the arachnoid mater and the pia mater is the subarachnoid space. So this subarachnoid space is filled with the cerebrospinal fluids, and the space between the that will be dura mater and arachnoid mater subdural space, that will be filled with the interstitial fluids. This CSF will encirculate inside the brain through the ventricle cavity. It will also form in the choroid plexus of the ventricles, where the ependymal cells will be there. Through the filtration and secretion of the blood capillaries, the choroid plexus present in the ventricles. So, once the CSF formation ho raha hai, and the CSF having the vital roles, we have all have seen. Now these are the reference book. Through this reference book you can go and you can study the well about the these meninges and cerebrospinal fluids. Like Tartora is here, Bell Melinda is there, Robin and Cotton is there, and White King is there. So these are the standard books. You can also follow the Ross and Wilson will be there, that have the well explanation about the nervous system. Okay, so till then, thank you. We will meet again in the next class with new and interesting topic. Till then, thank you.